Hi guys, it's nearly 20 past 2 in the afternoon, and I've got some parcels from Hong Kong. So, it just says clock on this one, so I'm guessing this is the clock. This one's padded out, the other one it isn't. Let me just see if I can skim along the edge. Hopefully. Yep. Nothing else in there is no. I'm gonna have a bit of a tidy up in the bedroom when I've done this. Nice bit of foam padding, and there be the clock and all its pieces. So that's gonna be fun to put together. Ah, there is an instruction sheet for it, that's good. I don't know if it's readable. We'll find out. Right, next. This one's the 66p doorbell. Different sellers posted exactly the same way. Dun dun dun. It's a conspiracy. Right. Oh joy, there's no instructions for this one. Yeah, that's going to be fun then, isn't it? All marked on the board anyway, so what have we got? We got four of the same resistors. This should be exactly the same as what Julian Illett bought. Illett? I can't remember. He did say how his name was pronounced once, but I can't remember. So, we've got four resistors, they're all the same. Everything, well, that's why I keep everything in one place. Not the speaker. And a bloody ceramic cap. I think the ceramic caps are all the same. But there's the speaker. There's one big electrolytic, which is 100 microfarad, 25 volt. And we've got, if I can get hold of it. A little one that I need my magnifying glass to read, and I don't know where it is. I think that was a 10 microfarad one. And we've got, I think they're Zener diodes. Memory serves correct, I've got three of them. I only need two, so I've got a spare one. I can tell from the way the pins are bent, these are all just, picked out from a pile of parts and thrown into a bag. We've got the chip and the little socket for it. Which conveniently shows you on the board which way around to put it. Little momentary button. Four pieces of wire. Two will be for the speaker, two will be for power. And of course, three little ceramic caps down there. So, that's going to be fun. I had it round the wrong way. There we go. Your speaker is labelled up this top corner. That's power. Positive and negative. Electrolytics go here. Yeah, I was right. 10 microfarad is that little one. And 100 one goes above it. 47k resistors, and there's four of them. One there, and three in a row there, and the two diodes down the bottom. The button, and the chip. That's, pretty damn simple. So, that on there like that, and I would have slap solder on the other side. There's a little dimple on these sockets, which you'd match. I'm just going to put that back in its foam, so the pins don't get bent. Just match it with a little dimple that's on the circuit board. Things will be clearer, because I'm going to assemble this with a better camera, not this one. I'm sorting it out. I'm going to sort it out, so I can hopefully use this thing. But what I'm going to do, just so I don't lose everything, I'm just going to stick it back in this packet. I've got two lots of kitty cat spew to clean up in the bedroom, and sort those DVDs out so I can get the big DVD racks out of the way. Come back here, you bastard. And gain access to the PC, because I'm going to need that if I'm going to use a VHS camera to do certain videos with. Because what I'm going to do, I'm just going to set that Panasonic up on the bracket above my head and just let it record. If it records any fuck-ups, then it records the fuck-ups that are going in the video as well. There we go, in its little Ziploc bag. As it's nearly 2:30, I'm guessing I'm not seeing mum today. This one is a little bit more complicated, because it's got a few more parts with it. Oh, it has. I was just wondering if I had the chip and the chip socket for with it, and it has. That's right. Yeah. That's right then. Not that wire matters, because I couldn't just solder the chip straight to the board. And so I'll do the smallest, simplest one first before I do that one. You know, there's no point jumping straight in at the deep end, so to speak, is the right. I'm actually dying for a piss, but I'll wait just for a minute. You're all right on there for now, Nemo, but I will clean up in here later as well. Yeah, he's throwing up some of his cat food there. Got some old stuff down there to clean up. Which I'm going to do first. I have to get some access over here and sort of, well, so I can access the Sony Vaio machine. Because that's the one that's got all the software and connectors on it to connect things like, well, DVD players, video players, camcorders, etc. to it, to transfer tape to computer, basically. Pardon me. Oh, that reminds me. I've actually had about 4 hours sleep. Because I think, and that's only because I Google the symptoms, but I think it's possible I could have what I call acid reflux disease. Because I do get a lot of heartburn. I do get a lot very burpy sometimes, and it might not, it might just be general heartburn, but I don't get it every day. But last night I was laying in bed just about to doze off. I just had this gush of stomach acid just boom, straight up into my throat and into my fucking nose and everywhere. Just a rush. Because I sleep on my front, and that's probably not the best ways of sleeping, to be honest. But, I think I must have spent about 20 minutes to half an hour with a burning sensation in my throat and nostrils till I managed to clean it out, you know. Bit of a, you know, not, you know what I mean. No. I stand corrected. That's mum. I'm going to have go take a piss and I'll finish my story later. Okay. I don't think my batteries actually know what they're doing at the minute. These were freshly charged. That's glowing red. Anyway. Yeah, I think I had a bit of acid. Now it's on green. Make your fucking mind up, batteries. Anyway, alright. I have to change them. Anyway. Yeah, as I was saying before Mum turned up. I think I had a bit of acid reflux. I was just laying in bed and, on the front, and whoosh, up it came. Straight up my fucking nose as well. So that burnt. Then I needed to take a crap. So while I'm sitting on the throat, I've got my head over the sink, so I'm like, in the sink, you know, trying to get it all out of my nose and whatnot. There weren't a great deal up there, to be honest, but it still wasn't pleasant. Well, I did Google it just for the hell of it, and it could be acid reflux. Because I do actually get heartburn on a regular basis, which is normal. It can cause burps. Well, you know, watching my videos, I burp a lot. So that might explain it. So I may actually have to cut out all sources altogether. Apparently there's two possible causes for acid reflux. First one being the valve to your stomach doesn't close properly, so it lets some of it out, especially when you're lying down. The second could be a type of hernia, where normally your stomach sits below your diaphragm, but it comes up above your diaphragm. That's another possibility. I've got a bit of a sore throat after that last night, actually. Yeah, it wasn't pleasant. And, I've got a friend on Facebook here. She is mad about buses. That's all I ever see on here, buses. And actually, one of her friends, she's transgender as well, and, my transgender friend has just messaged me. It's a voice message, and I bet it's related to what I'm about to tell you. But there's this dick on there who's trying to tell her she's wrong about a bus. Now, it's a Volvo V12B, built by a coach builder I can't pronounce the name of. Pity it wasn't Claxton, because that's a nice, easy one. Now, I don't know shit about buses, so I did Google it, and I have found umpteen of these Volvo buses on Google, so I don't know if this guy's just being a prick deliberately, or if he is just actually genuinely mistaken and just won't admit it. I don't know, but yeah, it is the bus that this young girl is saying it is. There. Yeah, that's getting to me. Right. Well, as I only had 4 hours sleep last night, I've decided I'm not going to play with these electric kits today, electronic kits rather, because I'm not quite with it enough to do something, you know, that fiddly. Cleaning up, I'm fine. My head is working well enough to do a bit of tidying up and sorting, so that's just what I'm going to spend the rest of the day doing. It shouldn't take me too long. I'll start cleaning that cat sick up in the bedroom. Then move on to the DVDs and sort the DVD racks out. I actually think I could double them DVDs up on that, on those racks I bought. Show you. Oh no, magically my battery's gone to full charge. I think I know what it is, actually. Because I tape the battery door closed, if it comes open just a smidge, even though it's still contacting, it'll register the batteries as low, so I'm trying to keep my fingers off that door. I think there might be enough room in here to get to. I'm actually wondering if that's like a VHS tape stand, maybe? Or if it is designed to get like two DVDs in, because you look at how thick the DVD case is. I should get at least two in each divider on this. I don't know where Nemo's disappeared to. Stupid question. Alright, well out of date now, I'm not going to trust them. Right. Yeah, I am actually seriously contemplating just calling it a day with sources. Because it's not often I get such a reflux like that in bed. It's quite rare. But I did want to have two antacids before I settled to go to sleep, and I actually fell asleep before I had the second one. Might have been the reason. I just had a gut feeling I should have had the two, but like I said, I fell asleep. But, yeah, I've actually had it worse than that, you know, where it's sort of choking me. That is really unpleasant, you know, when you're sort of choking and you're gasping for breath, but you can't because you're fucking... system is full of stomach acid. That is horrible. That really is a horrible feeling. I'm sick down there as well. You're an asshole at times, Cat, but I can't blame you for that, can I? Not really. I'm starting in the bedroom, I think. Anyway, that'll give me some extra time to, play with some cameras. That's probably because I just had a drink on that. Could use this one and just... that would work. You know, it's got the tape already in it. I've just got to find a thing. It's an 8.5 volt adapter. 8.4, near enough. That 0.1 of a volt won't make a difference. I don't know, that's quite a large one. That's why I was going to use that one. Or one of them. I can set a power adapter up, but I've got an 8.5 volt adapter, but I don't think the plug's going to fit. I really don't. It's actually a old... what's that, a PlayStation 2 portable thing? I don't think this plug's going to fit. Nope. I do need to find something to power that with. I may have to try and find one of my little universal adapters and just power it with that. It's either that or I butcher that 8.5 volt one, because I don't need it. And I could put a plug on it that does fit this. That's not near enough. Near enough the right voltage, isn't it? This is 8.5, I think it says on there, yeah. 0.1 of a volt difference, that's not going to make an ounce of difference with that. Yeah, I might actually go through some of my old adapters and see if I can find one that fits that camera and then just sort of butcher it onto the adapter, its power supply itself. Fucking hell. Kitchen roll. Kitchen roll, then I'm going to make a bit of room down here somehow. Fuck, I need a cat there, don't I? So I get them boards leaned up in here ready. Because it's not ideal having them out there by the front door. Because, well, God forbid, but if there's a fire in here, I'd trip over and trying to get out. Victory will soon moan if they see him there as well, which in a sense I don't blame them. In the most ideal of places. I'm definitely keeping this old Samson. This works really well. And I've got spare tapes for it and whatnot. I think I paid a tenner for that one alone that came with all the necessary charges and whatnot. Right, but before I do anything... yeah, that just looks like cat food. There was a hairball down here somewhere. I'm gonna get all that shit chucked in there. That box hopefully chucked up on top of it for the time being. I've got a feeling the start cap or run cap is going on that fan. Which is what happened to my old floor fan, which I've actually just found out Sainsbury's are doing them for £20. So guess what I'm going to get next time I get paid? Only because I can adjust it better on there and I get my chair back as well. Then I'll put that one, I don't know, perhaps in here. Not that I've really needed them that much this year, but anyway, I'm going to disappear and get some work done, and I will report back. Well, I've made some progress in the bedroom. Probably after I've done those DVD racks, so talk good. This camera is now starting to fuck me off. I'll try again. Fucking piece of shit. Right. Swearing over. As you can see, I've got the little Panasonic set up. Now, the connector from this 5-volt one fits and powers up the system fine. However, this one, I've got rated at 7.5 volts. It does say on the back of these, in, oh, 7.9. 7.5 shouldn't be far off. Now the next one up is 9. That would be too high, but this, let's see, it's working. So we'll unplug that. Plug this one in. Now working. I'm going to take this down a notch. Another notch. Nope. I think there's power coming out of that. I'll have to double check it. It was working. If not, I've got this spare end here which I was using to power lights with from for the Lego Town when I had them on there. I'll find something. For now, I'm going to unplug. Well, actually, it's not going to hurt being plugged in. I'll just take it out. But hopefully tomorrow, if I get a chance, I'm going to build those circuits and I'll film it using this. If I have to use the 5-volt one, I'll use it. It does power up and work, so that's a good experiment to see if the 7.5-volt charger works. We'll plug it into this camera. Hang on, what's the voltage input on this one first? It is 8.4, not quite enough. It could go at 9 volt, but put that in. Yep, it's charging. See the little LED flashing? So it's charging. Stand this up here and that can charge. I'm still charging that when I turned it on to take the cassette out to put in this one. This has now got cassette and, well, it seems like it'll only accept a 2GB max memory card. Because you can take still photos with this as well as video. And I know you can put video to the SD card, because when I took the SD cards out that were already in these cameras, they had some short videos on them. Very short, because they're very small SD cards. Very small SD cards. Which I think I've actually put in there, if memory serves correctly. So, that's the plan. I have got any necessary AV cables and whatnot. I think that's all hidden under here. USB, DV, and there's another port down there which I can't quite see upside down. Let's have a look at this one as it's in the light. Oh, that one's blocked. Okay. it's got an S video there, and the S video out. But do I have the correct cable for that? So I can't remember if my PC capture card's got an S video doodad in it. Let's have a look. Anyway, I'm actually getting hungry. I'm going to show you the bedroom quickly. There we go, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 racks in total with them DVDs. I might actually go through them and I might get rid of a few. Some I've had for... some I've had for ages and whatnot. I don't watch, so... that time I had a massive cleanout, I think. That solar light doesn't know whether to turn on or turn off. I'll have to have a look at my drawer at the bottom there for necessary cables. One of these days we'll do something with this door and all. Yeah. These over here. I know a guy on YouTube, he doesn't post a video very often, it's UXW Bill. He uses VHS cameras to make his videos. Shame he doesn't post very often. Oh look, it's still frickin' raining. I do wish this rain would do one so we can actually have a fucking summer. It is really getting depressing now. Right. Boom. Make myself some sarnies. That was 6 minutes, I thought I said eight for a second. I'm gonna make myself some egg mayo sarnies. I don't know whether to do it with salad cream or to do it with mayonnaise. I do like salad cream, but if I've got an acid reflux problem, that's not a good idea. That's probably not a good idea either, it probably wouldn't matter. What is this like for sugars? Just out of curiosity. Half a gram per tablespoon, so not a lot. That's going to be better sugar-wise for me. That sod it, I'll use that and not rinse those out. Wash all that up. There's hot, clean water. There we go. Eggs are going to be peeled and mushed. I've got a clean fork somewhere. I can't remember where I put it. But I have got a clean fork. Mum suggested that might help if I actually have two pillows. So I've thrown the other one back on the bed. I can do the clean pillow slip on it, really. So I used to have two pillows. But when Mum and my stepdad and my youngest brother stayed here when they lost their house because of the bloody landlord, I didn't have that many pillows myself, so I gave up one off my bed to give to them to use. And I've actually got a few spares in the cupboard, so it doesn't matter. But I just, when they got their own place and moved out, I just never put a second pillow back on the bed. So, but Mum said keeping my head up, sleeping on my back would help as well. Like I said, I use antacids and they help quite a lot. Actually, I had one earlier because I was feeling a little bit of heartburn. Anyway. Right. Get these washed up. Get some bread butter. I've gone back on wholemeal bread. I swap. I don't don't know why. I get bored of using the same bread all the time, so I'll just swap the wholemeal every now and again. Now I've found out it's not a gluten problem I have. Well, brown bread helps, but it ain't actually that much difference in it, so I just think I've got fucked up. Well, I've got a fucked up body, to be honest. I just seem to be finding lots of various things going wrong with me at a money 32. And if you really want me to be honest, I don't think I'm going to reach much past my 50s, to be honest. I really don't. I actually think I'm going to have a relatively short life. I suppose, depending on how you look at life, could be a bad thing, could be a good thing. obviously, I don't want to go before Mum. Or Dad. I'd rather, obviously it's going to hurt to lose your parents, like it always does. I know Dad can be a bit of a dick at times, but who can't be a dick at times? Even I'm a dick at times. I'm a dick on Facebook quite a lot, actually. But, there's a lot worse people out there I could have had for a dad. He was always there for me, he always did things for me. He was always the one that carried out the punishments. Yeah, grounded, yes, Dad. He wouldn't let us, either me or my brother, because I'm going back before my youngest brother and my sister were born. We weren't allowed outside to play until we'd done our chores, which was not that many, actually, and nothing great, just do the dishes, feed the dogs, I should say, because we always had two, and that was it. And then during summer, we could go off and play in the evenings, and go home, at a certain time. At least one of us would have a watch or something. We didn't have mobile phones back then. Now I do feel old. I really do feel old now. Back in my day, I actually thought I would be saying things like that when I was a lot older, not 32. Anyway. Weekends we'd have an extra chore or two to do before we disappear out to play. Mine was usually clean up the dog's mess in the garden. We were never like one of these dog owners that just left the dog's mess in the garden to build up. It was always cleaned up. If there was any litter blowing around the garden, I'd pick that up as well. And of course, Dad would go around and inspect and make sure we did a good enough job. If not, we'd get an earache when we got back. I can't complain. Mum doesn't like Dad anyway. Well, if she did, they'd still be married. But they're not, so yeah. Well, I suppose being married to someone would be different. I was just reading something on YouTube from Boogie 29998. Oh no, it isn't. From something else. Apparently, big YouTubers get shut down. Drive-by shooting. Actually, oddly enough, now that I've mentioned Boogie 2988 rather. Always get the numbers wrong for his username. He hasn't been shut down. A video 4 days ago. If he'd have been shut down, he wouldn't have a channel, would he? It wouldn't be here. Support this channel. Click here to support Boogie2988. Every bit helps. I could put that button on my channel, but I very much doubt that'll ever get hit. I think you've got to have Google Wallet anyway. I can't be arsed with all that. I use PayPal and that is it. PayPal's a big enough pain in the ass as it is. Anyway, I've rambled on enough, so I'm going to go get something to eat. And I'll be back one more time later before I shut the video down. This camera hasn't done it for me. No, it hasn't. It's got a habit of doing that. Said low battery earlier and turned off, and I'm getting full bars on the battery symbol, so... Right. Should we see if we can do this last part without the camera dying? Sirens! I can hear sirens. No surprise, really. I'm in a town, what do you expect? Right. One or two I can hear. Just the one, I think. Oh. Better remember to put my coat in the fridge. Oh shit. Oh fuck. Crawlers to put up there. There we go. One of these is a broken one. I can't remember which one. One of them's got a broken... that one. You can kind of sort of see the stickers on the wonk. It's got a wonky stick. Work. It just feels wonky. Right. It smells a bloody egg. That is the arse about doing an egg sandwich like those. You stink the place out. But I'm actually wondering. I bought some of these bags of sweets. I had a bag of these last night, and I had that acid reflux. Maybe it was these. It's the only thing different I've had since the last time it happened. Which was last year, I think. I can't remember such an incident happened. Like I said, it's very, very few and far between. I'm guessing this controller I got with all them PlayStation bits is a PlayStation 2 from the colour. I've always wondered if PS2 controllers will work on PS1. I know PS1's controllers will work on a PS2. But, what have I got? I've actually got three spare PS1 controllers. Four spare PS2. And the really daft thing is, I could probably sell them for about £5 each on eBay. £5 minimum. Yeah, I've got just the one. Like this, I've got four total for the PS1. Well, five, if I count the one through here. For the PS1 in here. That's a tire. I've got a list of accessories you can get for the PS2 in the back here. Memory card. Analog controller. A multi-tap. I have one. DVD remote control. Don't have that. S-video cable. I've got that. RFU adapter. I've got several of those spare as well. AV adapter. I've got those for the PS1, and I do believe that one. Yes, that has one, so yep, I've got that. Component AV cable, I've got that. Well, I don't have the SV cable, I was thinking of something different. I was actually thinking of the component AV cable. A vertical stand, no, I don't have that. Horizontal stand, no, memory card, PS1 multi-tap, and a mouse.
Really?
You get a mouse? Why would you want a mouse? I'll go in the recycling bin tomorrow. More frickin' bubble wrap. If I ever decide to put one of my laptops up on eBay as spares or repairs, I'll need that. Pardon me. Might have to go get an anti-acid. Not an anti-acid, an antacid. Fucking anti-acid. Right. You got food in your dish. We did it. Do you know, when he meowed, I actually thought he was in the kitchen. Sounded just like he was in the kitchen. I don't even know what to do with this lot. The gun and the reload pedal here. Take to the bedroom. But got an extra cable here, don't mean. Got the RF cable. So I don't really need the PS1, but no, I've got a choice. I could keep it just as a spare. But then again, I don't really have the room, do I? I don't actually know why I bought this gun in here, to be honest. It's for the PlayStation 2, so it should be in the lounge with all the games up that corner, but I can't quite get there at the moment, so I'll stick it in here for now out of the way. I don't know. One of my subscribers tell me what they think. Should I keep it or should I test it and sell it on? Rubbish. Bits of the old camera dotted around. Part of me actually wants to do some soldering tonight and build that kit, but I'll wait. If I'm successful with both of these kits, I'll get a bigger kit, which I'll probably break down into segments because that would get long. These little kits I could do in one video. If I do a larger one, because there's a larger clock I'd like, it's got a few more features on it and whatnot. A couple of extra digits. These cables, again, I don't really need them, but I will keep them. Oh, hello. Ah. I wonder if that cable would work, because it looks like a composite cable, whatever it's fucking called. Now we got SCART lead as well. The rest is all cables. The PlayStation was even an original demo disc. I'll definitely keep that. Ah, there is something that's either in my end of my sock or the end of my boot. But it's bloody sharp, and it keeps poking me in the toe. Every so often, that pokes me in the toe. Anyway, once I've just gone and put a lock through Claudia, I'll kick my boots off for the night anyway. I mean, I've even got the original book with it. And this is for the PS2. Oh yeah, it is for the PS2. Alright. I'll keep that for mine then. Boo-hoo, I don't have it. Question is, I've just realised, is the demo disc actually in here? It's a PlayStation 2 disc. I actually don't have many PlayStation 2 demos, if any at all. So I just picked up those few bits, and it's already looking better up this corner. It always looks worse than it actually is. Obviously, I'm not going to take any scrap down to the trailer tonight. Yeah. Can't put polystyrene in the recycle bin. Hello. British plugs always come with one of those when you get them new. I have absolutely no idea why. There's another PlayStation 2 thing. Got any bikes to do at the moment? Well, the only thing I've got to do, look, big belly. The only thing I've got left to do is swap the wheels around between the Rally Max and the Giant. I could call the Giant Dwayne, you know. Dwayne the Rock Johnson, as it is a giant rock. But I think that would just be totally sad. It's even sadder than naming the bikes. Ah. Just to inlay for the Scorpion gun. Is there any instructions on this bloody thing? There is, actually. It doesn't say how you connect everything up, because I've never actually used one on any of the PlayStations. So I don't actually have the foggiest idea how you connect them, but it must be self-explanatory. Hell, if I can set up a PC, I'm sure I can plug one of those into a bloody console. Can't be that bleeding hard, can it? Can it? Right. Well, I'm not going to be doing anything interesting. I'll probably go on the scrap, as that's no good. The bike is actually riding fine with funny-sized bearings in it, so... I know it'll come apart again if I do have to replace them. 10:30, so I might just pick up any rubbish I see in here. And the bike bits I'll probably just bag up for now. Just to give me a bit of room, there's a bit less to do tomorrow as well. I won't have to be asked for the shelf tonight. Right. Alright, that's it for the video. I suppose I could box up the bits, but those bike bits aren't going to hang around for long anyway before I put them in the designated boxes. Are we still charging? We are still charging. Good. Yep. I do believe I don't think I bought it from the same seller, but this is the same clock a YouTuber I watch bought and built, which wasn't actually intentional, but I've just realised, looking at all the components and the circuit board layout and whatnot in there, that's the exact same one. But there's numbers of sellers on eBay that sell these at various different prices, so... It's got a nice blue colour on that side, I like that. Looking forward to starting on that, which I plan to do tomorrow, I hope. So, without further ado, I've got to find my USB cable. Is it still plugged in? It is. Don't fit. I'll put that over here actually out of the way. Right. Bollocks. Okay. Just dropped it. Is that the cable? That's the one. Right. Well. Thanks a lot for watching, and thanks a lot for bearing with me with this camera. Albeit, the electronics videos I do might be done on VHS tape, but I'll probably be better quality than this. Well, at least it does look good on the LCD screen, so we'll see. So, thanks for watching. And the next video you should see tomorrow night, I hope, would be me building this one. I could have packaged them a bit better, but, eh, can I really complain for free shipping all the way from, you know, around the world, from Hong Kong, and they have got here undamaged, so, but, yeah, I think if that was me, I'd have use the box or something, just a little box to put in, but never mind. Maybe it's cheaper for them to do it that way, I don't know. Anyway, thanks for watching, I'll talk to you all again tomorrow when we build up the doorbell. Ding dong!